Hello and welcome to ACP Presents Metal and Might, Veterans at Constellium. I'm your host, J.R. Williams, and I'm excited to do some career exploration with you today. If you're joining us for the first time, this is a friendly reminder to make the most of our time together. Feel free to drop your questions in the chat as we go along. We'll answer them later during our Q&A session. And also don't forget to introduce yourselves and let us know where you're joining us from. We're all here to learn from each other and connect, so don't be shy. Today, we're talking about career opportunities and the innovative work culture at Constellium, a leader in development, manufacturing, and recycling of aluminum products and solutions. So whether you're transitioning out of the service or considering a career change, we have a wonderful lineup of experts ready to provide you with great advice and guidance as you plan your next steps. So please welcome today's guests, Andy Schreiber, John Michael Insetta, also known as JM, and Julian Robinson. And so we're going to start introductions with you, Andy.
Sure. My name is Andy Schreiber. I'm the head of talent acquisition here at Constellium, based out of our corporate office in Baltimore. Been here for about 1 year, and just last week began my first mentorship in ACP. So looking forward to continuing on that journey.
No, I love to hear that. So I guess we'll just go right into it. So tell us more about Constellium.
Absolutely. So I'm going to educate guys a little bit more about what Constellium is all about, who we are, what we do, and then pass it off to JM and Julian to share their inspiring stories as veterans and also active duty military and their transition from and even during their service into the corporate world. So as JR mentioned, Constellium, we're a leader of transforming aluminum into advanced solutions as well as recycling. So we manufacture, we also recycle and design solutions for specific customers and markets. So those markets primarily focus on packaging, automotive, and aerospace. We are a publicly traded organization with our headquarters being out of Paris. We have approximately 12,000 employees, 25 production facilities, and approximately about $7 billion euro in revenue. And you can go to the next slide. So we have operations worldwide through different markets across the globe. As you can see here, our operations on the North American side primarily are within the US with a joint venture in Canada, as well as a facility down in San Luis Potosi in Mexico. But our largest manufacturing facilities here in the US are in Muscle Shoals, Alabama, where both Julian and JM sit, Ravenswood, West Virginia, and then up in Van Buren, Michigan, which is a suburb of Detroit. Our primary headquarters is in Paris, but then we also do have three corporate offices, including Paris, Baltimore, where I'm located, as well as Zurich in Switzerland. And then we have three research and development centers, one in Plymouth, Michigan, once again, a suburb of Detroit, Verrettes, France, and then Brunel University, a partnership in London in the UK. So lots of different opportunities and locations across the globe, regardless of, you know, where you call home or where you may be stationed or where you may be transitioning out. As I mentioned before, we do a lot of recycling as well as innovation for our customers. So we do transform aluminum into rolled and extruded products and as well as automotive components. So you can see here just a simple illustration of the aluminum value chain. Fast fact, for those who may not be aware, aluminum is infinitely recyclable. It's one of the few materials that are. So when you see this closed loop process, it really is closed loop. Obviously, there's introduction of some product that comes in from extracted refining and smelting from some of our suppliers and partners. Where we take place in this value chain that you can see there highlighted in green is in the actual casting, rolling, and extrusion of that aluminum. Production development, as I mentioned previously, as well as recycling, which is a huge component, not only of our business, but also is our contribution, you know, and how we contribute back to the environment and the world by creating recycling solutions to keep the aluminum within that closed chain. So our products and solutions, once again, primarily rolled products. So that's everything that can be rolled for beverage cans that could be used for components in automotive, as you see there, components as well for the defense industry, as well as the aerospace and transportation industries, extruded products, as well as recycling. So once again, those being our core primary areas of business and focus. And then our markets, you know, we are a major global supplier of aluminum coils and sheets for beverage and food, as well as aerosols and cosmetic packaging. In automotive, which you'll see on the next slide in a second, some of our different partners that we do rolled products as well as extrusion components. Same with aerospace, and then some specialty products, especially for the defense market, which we do at our facility in Ravenswood, West Virginia. And so our customers, as you can see here with all the logos you'll recognize at the bottom, our different partners and different products that we supply and partner with them on, as well as sustainability, right? So as we think about recycled components, as we think of making lighter, faster automobiles with EV components and being able to return that energy back and get the most out of those, as well as how we do a lighter and greener beverage can. So working in partnership with can makers, as well as brewers and tooling manufacturers to make the most out of the recycled aluminum that we have that we can put back into that value chain that we reviewed previously. So a lot of different, very exciting opportunities and areas within Constellium. You know, from a career standpoint, we have everything from the operators and the technicians who are manufacturing our product every day, to the quality folks that are making sure it's meeting the specs that we need it to the engineers that are creating new products, as well as making sure our facilities are running in an efficient, effective manner. And then to, you know, folks like myself who work more on the corporate side of the business, supporting our people and our operations in the best way that we can. So regardless of what your MOS is, regardless of what you're looking to do as you transition out of the military, or in Julian's case, as you maintain active duty or a reserve status, there's definitely opportunities at Constellium for you.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. As we were going along, I didn't quite realize just how much you do at Constellium. Like, there's a lot of things going on, obviously. And then I also learned, I didn't know that aluminum is infinitely recyclable. So that's kind of cool.
Recycle your cans.
Right? Bring those cans. I don't know about anywhere else, but in New York, you at least get 5 cents if you turn them in. So now we know that goes into something a little bit greater. All right. Well, thanks, Andy, so much for sharing all of this with us. We're going to turn things over to JM for a little introduction and maybe talk a little bit about your journey there.
Great. Thank you for having me. This is quite an honor, actually. Could we flip to the next slide, please? Okay. A little bit about me. I retired last August. Combined ACRC service at 33 years. I first enlisted as a cannoneer in the field artillery, commissioned through ROTC as a second lieutenant in infantry. And my assignments range from platoon all the way to combatant command. Two deployments. One is a anti-armor company commander in Operation Iraqi Freedom 2. And then I was a combined joint task force chief of plan, in OEF 7. I began my mentorship with ACP back in August of 2022. I had a fantastic mentor. And luckily for me, he was the CFO here at Constellium. We never focused on employment with Constellium until later on in the internship when I expressed interest. But I did get a lot of exposure to other businesses and other disciplines in the manufacturing industry as a result of my mentorship to try to figure out which was a good fit. I knew that I didn't want to have a suit and tie sit behind a job desk. That just wasn't for me. So as I started to go and visit different manufacturing facilities and different businesses, I came to Muscle Shoals and took a look at the facility we have here, and I knew this was where I needed to be. Fun fact about our plant here, one in every eight cans come through Muscle Shoals. So I like to tell the folks that I work with here that we have millions of college students that are depending on a quality product to roll out the door here for their fun time in college. So I began my professional career outside of the Army. I started an internship here at Constellium in early 2023. And in May of 2023, I was offered a position as the leadership development and planning manager here. We, as a company, had made a decision that we needed to invest time and money into our frontline leaders. So those leaders that are at the tip of the spear, we wanted to help develop them and help them grow, become better leaders, and hopefully move up within the industry as they perfect their trade and get better at what they do. I'm currently a one of one, but we are launching a global frontline leadership program in Q4 of this year to get after all the other plants here in North America and Europe and transition that program to the frontline leaders there. So that's me in a nutshell. I love working here. I get up for work every day and I'm excited. I don't have to put on a suit and tie. You know, I put on steel toe boots and jeans and a shirt and off I go. And I spend a lot of time out on the floor with our frontline leaders, which I used to love to do in the Army, is to get out, you know, with our troops out on the line. So subject to your questions, I will turn everything over to Julian.
Yes, Julian, tell us a little bit about yourself. I know right before the webinar, we were talking about your journey to your unit in South Carolina. So we'd love to hear how you balance your service with your work.
Okay. You know, my name is Julian Robinson, and I got 10 years of military service, all National Guard time. I was honored to be able to deploy with 1221st Rock Clearance Company out of Graniteville, South Carolina. And I was a part of Operation Inherent Resolve. And I rotated from Kuwait, Iraq, and Syria. I currently hold three MOSs, 92 Alpha, 12 Bravo, and 88 Mike. On the weekends, I leave Alabama and travel to South Carolina for my duty once a month. And I get a lot of support from my manager. And it's good, you know, working at Constellium. And I came here last year, August of 2023, and I came and viewed the site and everything. And one thing that really stuck out to me about the whole thing was when I went to the CAF and I did a tour of the CAF, and I saw how veterans had their names on plaques and their years of service. And that really stuck out to me a lot, that out of all the companies I've been around, you know, being in steel industry, paper and pulp industry, I never saw that. And just to honor their veterans, that was really a big plus. And I've been here. I started off as a technical planner. I did a little short stint as a reliability engineer. Now I'm the maintenance crane planner for the site, all cranes. And it's been a challenge, but I have great support and a great mentor that helps me along the way.
All right. Well, I think we're going to go into a little bit of Q&A, but I want to start just with you, JM and Julian, just, you know, because you've made the transition from military to Constellium. And also, it's just great to hear about that commitment to honoring veterans and the military community. So I think we'd love to learn just a little bit more about that. So I guess I would ask both of you, you know, how would you describe Constellium's culture? If you could talk just a little bit more about the culture, and then also, you know, how you see others become successful in your organization. So let's see, start with you, JM.
Okay, so I would say here in Muscle Shoals, this is somewhat of a family business. We have a lot of folks out in the shops there that are second and third generation aluminum workers here at Constellium. Obviously, we've been under a different ownership over the years, but it is a culture of what I would say family. Very professional, and from our operators all the way up the chain. And in some ways, some of the things that we did as leaders in the military, they're a direct correlation to what we do here. You know, we plan, we execute, we AAR, and you know, we get after the new plans as they come up. So it for me, it was an easy transition. I have been told that when I do my training sessions that I have to take a step back a little bit, as you know, as far as my style. You know, I'm somewhat used to training soldiers and not facilitating, but very well, I've been very well accepted into the culture here. And like I said before, I love coming to work every day.
Oh, I love, I also have that similar problem, JM. my focus is very, you know, ingrained. But Julian, what about you? What do you like about the culture? And what do you see as like ways to succeed in the company?
Definitely, I would say the safety culture is a big plus.
Yeah,
I love it. I love the safety culture here. That's really one of my favorite things about the company, safety culture. And I would say commitment, you know, being committed to coming to work and doing a good job. And, you know, respect is also another good one. I see that a lot. You know, some of the most friendliest people I've met here, and, you know, treat everybody with respect. And I feel like it'll take anyone a long way in their career. If they do those three things, work safe, be committed, and have respect, they'll go far in their career here.
I keep telling Julian he's got to stop calling me sir.
Oh, baby steps, right? All right. Right. Well, and actually, Andy, if you wouldn't mind, you know, giving some of your thoughts too, like how does someone, you know, come out of the service or, you know, still serving National Guard Reservists, but how do you come from the military community and stand out as a competitive candidate when you're applying to Constellium?
Yeah, I mean, for us, you know, as you look across MOSs and you look across different specialties, there's a lot of transferable skills that you are taught in the military, not only just hard skills, but the soft skills too. You know, things like Julian was just talking about, you know, whether you're in the military or you're in the private sector, you know, those all transition over. And so, you know, being a competitive candidate is all about highlighting, you know, why you're the best person for the role, but also why the role is the best fit for you. So, you know, as we evaluate candidates, as we interview candidates, it's taking into consideration not just, you know, private sector or even industry experience. What does that person bring as a person, first and foremost? And so regardless of, you know, what you've done in the past or what you may be transitioning out of, you know, as I mentioned in the opening, there's a lot of variable opportunities across the entire organization and at our facilities or within our corporate functions where those skills do transition over. And of course, there's, you know, there's a little bit of a journey there. And JM and Julie may be able to speak more about what that actual transition is. But, you know, as we evaluate, we're taking those things into consideration.
Yeah, I think a lot of people who are preparing for their transition, or maybe they're out, but they're like, oh, I need to do something a little bit different. I think they'd be dying to know what paths did you take, Julian and JM? Like, how did you make those steps? I know, you know, JM, you had some help with a mentorship, but as you know, when you were really looking at the process, you know, what stands out to you as something that helped you, you know, stand out as a candidate?
So for me, excuse me, I didn't really know where my skills as an infantry guy would transition, you know, into the civilian world. And having looked at multiple disciplines in the different manufacturing industries, we really focused from the beginning on where we wanted to be, you know, having moved every 2 years for so many years. We wanted to set up shop for the family, and just coming, coming here to do a plant tour and looking at the community and then looking at the environment here, we knew that was where we wanted to be. We knew we didn't want to go back up into. We're both from New York, and we didn't want to go to a cold environment. So, you know, we looked at the frost line and focused everything below the frost line. But I just stayed flexible to every other opportunity that came my way. I pursued as much as possible. I networked. That is a big thing. Once you start talking to people in different industries, asking them, is there somebody else that I could talk to? I found that People are absolutely willing to give up their time to help if you ask for it. So that was really helpful for me. I was exposed to a whole bunch of different businesses. But like I said, you know, this is where we decided that it was good for us and good for, hopefully, for Constellium.
Right. And also, I hear you on that New York to warmer.
Yeah.
No, I mean, I think it's great. And also, like, you know, learning, like, okay, where do my skill sets, you know, fall into place, and how can I actually leverage them in ways that, you know, might not necessarily, you know, be top of mind. But Julian, who has, you know, is a 3 MOS holder, why don't you tell us about, you know, how, you know, taking those skill sets and figuring out how they apply to a position.
Well, on the military side, we use a GCSS Army, which is pretty much identical to SAP that we use here. So, you know, being an automated logistics specialist, it goes hand in hand with being a planner here. It's basically has a lot of similarities as far as keeping up with inventories and looking up parts and, you know, just the overall planning aspect of it. It has a lot of similarities. So that worked out perfect.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's great. I had no idea. So I'm sure if anyone is listening and you have a military background in logistics, this could be very exciting information to share during an interview. Anything else?
The other two, not quite as much, because truck driving, not really. But, you know, it has a lot to do with, you know, doing like checks and things like that. So, you know, paying attention to detail, that too. And then also with my second MOS 12 Bravo, it has a, you know, that's pretty much like common engineering, route clearance, and, you know, in-home breach and things like that. So that's more so on the law enforcement side, but it's still, I mean, you know, it teaches you discipline and things of that sort. So it still could kind of work its way in there somewhere, but definitely 92 Alpha is definitely it. Yes, ma'am.
Fantastic. Well, and also you mentioned earlier, like, culture of safety, which I think is ingrained in all military service members, you know, safety first, right? Actually, I had a friend in safety who said it's mission first, but safety always, right? So always want to be safe. Awesome. So let's talk about, you know, career progression. How does that work? So once you're in, you know, how do you move to that next level?
Sure. So, I mean, there's a variety of different paths that you can take within Constellium. And we also have some award-winning development programs that we've recently taken home a Brandon Hall Silver Award for with our leadership development program. We also have a global engineering development program. Some of the sites also have different apprenticeship programs that they run as well, specific to the site or specific to certain roles. So, you know, in terms of getting into Constellium, there's a lot of different paths. And then, you know, creating your own path through Constellium. You know, obviously there's the traditional, you know, follow each step, you know, types of paths in different, you know, in different areas or different specialties. But as Julian has shown, you know, even in his somewhat short time with Constellium, those paths can take different routes while still continuing to contribute not only to your career, but also to, of course, the mission, vision, and goals of Constellium as well. So, you know, I would say there's not one specific path per se, but you kind of get to make your own, as well as the support of, you know, formal mentorship programs and those formal development programs that I mentioned previously. So I don't know if JM or Julian have any additional insight or thoughts there, but essentially that's our strategy around those pieces.
So the majority of our workforce here at Muscle Shoals are operators in maintenance, techs out on the manufacturing floor. And one of the programs we're striving to launch, hopefully before the end of the year, is where we are identifying those frontline folks that show leadership potential. And we'll pair them up with a mentor within the organization here and get them prepared for the production supervisor or maintenance manager's position, which is really the first leadership position in the plant. And that way they have more of a warm start when they promote within the business. And from there, if they really want to excel, they can move up, within the plant or within any of the other sites that we have within the business. They can continue to move up the ladder in leadership positions.
So Julian, did you want to add anything too?
No, ma'am.
Okay. No problem. Just wanted to check. It sounds like there's like a lot of opportunities. So it's really just, you could write your own ticket, and the fact that everyone seems so willing to share, like you have to ask, right? And I think sometimes that's the struggle for those who are watching and you've already been out and you're not sure how to get promoted in your civilian career. These are great tips to kind of figure out, okay, how do I reach that next step? So why don't we talk a little bit more about, so what about early career options at Constellium? Maybe some options for those who have recently either they did their tour, they got out, they got their degree. So now they're really looking at their first civilian job. So for people just kind of starting, what advice would you have?
Take the opportunity to network. In my mind, you have to really decide on what you want to, what do I want to be when I grow up? Where can I excel? Where can I bring my skills and make the best impact in the business? And don't be afraid to reach out to people that are in different businesses and ask. I've seen over the last couple of decades as we're bringing our young men and women home from combat tours and they leave the service and go into the civilian world, they're met with a good reception and people want to help and people want to impart their wisdom on those folks. So I would say as you're starting out your career, figure out what you want to do, have a path, obviously get a mentor through ACP, and understand, I think one of the biggest struggles that some people have is, we don't hire generals in the Army, we build them. And it's the same in corporate America. You may not step out of your position in whatever branch of the service that you're in into a position of equal responsibility. You have to prove yourself in the marketplace. So that would be the biggest advice I would give.
Yeah, I think that's fair. I think that if you're transitioning out, you kind of have to consider like there are some things to learn. There's some teachable moments out there. But if you're open to it, you'll get them, and then you'll be able to progress. Julian or Andy, is there anything else you wanted to add to that before we move on?
No, ma'am. Yeah. Okay. I hit on everything. He did great.
JM took most of my talking points. I
totally unplanned.
but it's once again, it's having that open-minded mindset, building a vision for yourself, and then interacting with people who are in those roles or have been through similar journeys, or you can connect with any of the three of us. We're more than happy just to give you guidance and advice. I think what you find is a lot of people are afraid to reach out, kind of cold, or build those relationships. But the reality of it is most of us are more than happy and willing to knowledge share and give guidance, even if it's not through, I just want everyone to do ACP, but even if it's not through a formal program. Especially when it comes to veterans, I think people do feel a duty to, help and to be that partner to help with that future journey or the next step in their career journey. So build a vision, seek out the right people, build those connections. Very, very similar to what JM had indicated.
Yeah, I made a note when you said networking, because that for me, it's funny because I have a real struggle asking people. I have a hard time reaching out to be like, hey, could you share some information with me? But if someone reaches out to me, I'm like, yes, what do you need to know? How can I help you? Have you heard about ACP? So thank you, JM, for the ACP plug. Greatly appreciated. So obviously, you know, we'd like people to get some mentorship, but often, you know, reach out. If you meet someone who's talking about their job and talking about how they made their transition, chances are they want to help. So go ahead and reach out, make that connection. Don't be like me. Just force yourself to do it and you'd be amazed at what happens, right? So let's talk some more about, making yourself marketable. So taking your skills, do you need extra education? Are there certifications you should pursue if you're considering a role with Constellium? What are some of those, what do you recommend people do to prepare for a career with your company?
Yeah, Matt, I think a lot of that is dependent upon what you would like to do. So once again, kind of what we come back to talking, setting that vision for yourself, what's of interest to you, in terms of minimum levels of education, most of our roles, the base minimum level education is going to be a GED or a high school diploma. Obviously, through great programs, I know the DOD and the military run, you can have your associates, your bachelor's, your master's, all those other things. So there's varying levels of employment within Constellium, as well as specialty functions within Constellium. Some of those do require either certifications or at least some hours of active use. But once again, through a lot of the MOSs in the military, you are getting that experience. So I saw in the comments, they posted an MOS translator. I've guided people to that in the past, who I've had as veteran candidates, both at Constellium as well as in previous roles and organizations I've worked at. Don't shortchange yourself. There's a lot of things that you learn, you get accredited for, that you spend hours and hours and hours working on in the military that does directly translate or very closely translates. From a minimum standpoint, it'd be hard to cover all of it here in the time that we have, but I'd say if there's, once again, specific functions or specific specialties or roles that you're interested in, just do the research and then reach out to someone like myself, someone like Julian, someone like JM, and to get an idea of, hey, I've been looking at this role at this facility. I see I don't have, maybe one or two of the things you guys are asking for. Is there something maybe I did in the military that could potentially translate into the civilian world? Or how could I potentially get some experience doing that? And having those conversations. But I think overall preparation as a whole is, have a resume. I know there's great programs that the DOD offers in terms of transition and career guidance services. Once again, ACP and your ACP mentors can help with those things as well. And then having that kind of vision for what you want next. But I'll shoot it to Jamie and Julian if they have anything to add to that.
I would also offer up that you may not be right for a position that you're looking at within a certain organization, but if you've highlighted everything that you've done through your career, there might be an opportunity that they have that they would definitely look at you for. So like Andrew said, don't shortchange yourself. Get everything out there, all of your skills and accomplishments out there, because it may not be the job you're looking for, but there may be something else. Or, people within different industries run in the same circles, even if they're competitors. And if you network properly and you get all your skills out there, they would probably be more than happy to help, refer you to another company because of your skills. So, get it all out there is my recommendation.
So we did have a question that came in. So the question is, if my retirement date is July 2024, how soon would you advise me to submit my application for a job with your company? So what is the timing like for that?
Today. From the recruiting side. Yesterday. I think if you're a year away, you might want to be a little bit more intentional. The ability for any company, regardless, not even just Constellium, to hold jobs for a year, I'd say longer than a month or two, becomes difficult, because that rolls open because the business has a need, right? So I think for the right candidate, there's always considerations that can be made. But yeah, if you're retiring in July of 2024, I would apply as soon as possible. I mean, any hiring process in most organizations takes, you know, anywhere from a few days to a few weeks, depending on the role and the number of candidates. And, you know, we're coming into the fun time of year in recruiting where people are on vacations and you want to make sure that people interview with the right people and things like that. So we work our way through that, but I wouldn't hesitate. I'd say anything within 90 to 120 days of your retirement date is probably when you should start actively applying. Anything beyond that, I'd say you want to maybe be doing some active networking or just active searching. You know, go out on Glassdoor, go out on Indeed, go out on LinkedIn. Just look at the kinds of jobs, at the kinds of companies that you'd be interested in and what's available today. You know, there may be other opportunities that come available a little bit later that may match up better with the time frame. JM, Julian, feel free to add.
Yeah, I would say get your applications in as soon as possible. That I found that 90 to 120 day window across, you know, my transition was about the sweet spot. We don't have, or we have openings because we need that person now. And like Andy said, I couldn't think of a single opportunity that I was offered that they would have been willing to wait more than a couple months to bring me on board.
Yeah, I think that's interesting to know. So things do change during the summer months just because of vacations and things like that. So like, don't wait too long, but understand that there might be a little bit of a waiting game. So be patient. I think Tommy made some good advice as well. Anything else? No.
Julie, how did you find it with being, you know, active in the reserve? You know, did you find that application process different? If someone's active right now in the reserves, do you think they would go about that process any different? Or?
I don't think so. I wouldn't say that they would go by it any differently. It should be pretty much the same type of transition. I mean, but they'll still be, you know, still having drill like once a month and 2-week training during the summer. But like with me, when I was going through the hiring process, I had AT, my 2-week annual training was pretty much right at the time where I got hired. So they waited and extended my offer to compensate my military training. And that was big. That was big. So they let me come on board after my training.
Yeah, that does sound huge. I think a lot of people, they'd be very anxious, you know, like, hey, how's this going to work out? Because you can't exactly say no to AT, right?
No, I can't. I can't.
They're orders, not suggestions.
Right? Yeah. No. But is there anything else that Constellium does that, you know, as far as you being, National Guard, that makes it a little bit easier? I mean, you did talk about, you know, the respect and the honor for, you know, their service members. But is there anything else? Like, so if anyone else is out there watching in the Guard, in the reserves, and, you know, wondering about a company that, you know, welcomes that service, like, what other things can you tell us?
I could say just, you know, military leave, you know, I feel like just have, like, being able to have that military leave is great, you know, and, you know, as long as you communicate with your frontline leader, you know, you get off, you know, for your training. I never had any pushback, anything like that. And they're very supportive, you know, so that's good.
Awesome. So one thing that I did want to ask though, you know, what other opportunities does Constellium have for overseas applicants? Do you have anything? Because you're a global company, some service members get out and they like to stay where they're at. What would you say to that?
Yeah, so as I mentioned in the opening, we have various production facilities, corporate offices, and research centers across the globe, primarily in Europe and in North America, but we do have some in China as well. You know, in terms of overseas applications and things like that, obviously there's visa considerations and all those other fun things that come into play. But, you know, if someone were interested in maintaining, you know, work permissions overseas and would want to transition to a facility that's overseas, as long as they have the appropriate, you know, working permits and things like that, we're more than happy to take them as part of consideration. Same thing, you know, if there's a spouse that may be stationed overseas, that as long as they have the appropriate working permits and visas, we're more than happy to take, of course, their experience and everything into consideration as well. So, you know, the way that the organization is set up in North America, we have our core areas that I cover with you, or, you know, what we call PARP, our automotive business, as well as ANTs, aerospace and transportation. And we have sister facilities basically in Europe. So they're almost kind of mirrors of each other on opposite sides of the Atlantic. So the roles, the types of roles, the types of opportunities tend to be similar. So even if there were opportunities to start in one country and then come to another and things like that, we, you know, we encourage where and when possible internal mobility and global mobility for certain roles and certain specialties. So, you know, there's definitely, you know, opportunities for the right folks at the right time in the right place.
Okay, that sounds great. We also talked about military spouses. Are there other, you know, considerations that military spouses should look at when, you know, applying for jobs at Constellium?
Yeah, I mean, just my personal opinion and point of view, I don't think there's any differentiation there. I think, you know, we view them very much in the same way. In terms of formal programs or anything like that, I wouldn't say we have anything like that today in place. But once again, you know, as we look at someone holistically from a personal skills inventory, from a hard skills inventory, we're looking at that individual as a candidate first. And if they have situations with, you know, having to have coverage, if, you know, they have a partner that's going away for reserve service for the weekend or 2 weeks, and we have to have some flexibility. You know, I think as an organization, we do a really good job of being flexible around those things and realizing those accommodations when they need to be made. So I would highly encourage, you know, whether you're active duty, retired, reserve, or a spouse to check us out.
Well, and I can just vouch that at least everyone that I've spoken to at Constellium, really great people. So definitely at least make an introduction, get to know some good people. So we do have some time for more questions. So, you know, if you have a question, anything that you're dying to know, please put it in the chat. And in the meantime, while you're writing out your questions, I guess I'd like to ask each of you if you could share, you know, an experience at Constellium that, you know, when someone asks you what you do, that you share with them. So we'll start with you, Andy.
All right, so the question was, what do I do at Constellium? I'm sorry.
Or what do you like best about working at Constellium?
Oh, yeah. I mean, for me, like I said, I'm coming up on my 1 year on July 5th. So, you know, for me, just the welcome into the organization, how open and honestly just candid that folks were as I came in, you know, and starting from a point of trust, you know, as I come into my role into a new organization as a new leader in the organization. I think there's very much of a we're all in this together kind of mentality and attitude, which I absolutely love. So that's been my favorite thing. You know, I mean, everyone's going to say the people because the people are awesome. But at the end of the day, it really is all about the people, right? Not only do they make our workforce, but they make our days too, right? How we interact with each other, how we work together. Yeah, that would be my answer. I'll kick it to Julian.
Yes. I said, you know, earlier about the safety culture here. I feel safe when I'm here, you know. I definitely, and I spoke about the wall and the calf with the veterans, honoring the veterans. That's a major, major plus. I actually went home and was telling my parents about that when I went home to visit, because I've never seen that, and my parents never seen that. So that's a big plus. And then just having the support of coworkers and leadership, you know, it's not, if you got a question or you need to know something, they'll get you an answer. And I definitely like that. And that's great.
So I can say that up until I stepped foot in the Muscle Shoals plant, I don't think I ever looked at a beverage can and thought, geez, I wonder how they make that. But this is really a cool process. I didn't pay attention in chemistry class. So when we rolled up to the first step of the process is where, you know, we produce molten metal element 13. And I was asking the fellow that was giving me the tour, I said, yeah, how did you come up with E13 as the first part of the process? And he said, element 13, aluminum. I was like, okay. So I've told that story to some of the folks in the plant, because, you know, I just think it's a fantastic process. It's really neat. I know that there's on YouTube, there's a video on how metal cans are made, and I've showed it to the folks here, and it was really enlightening to me. But like Andy said, I mean, if people ask me, what do you like best about your job? It's that I get to talk to fantastic people every day. I get to help them try to develop as leaders. And it's just a great company to work for.
All right. Well, it looks like we don't have many more questions. So I think that what we can maybe do is just give any last minute advice or tips to anyone considering joining the amazing team at Constellium, and just, you know, tips or things to consider.
Hi, Jam.
Hey, we want the best of the best here, right? We're a world-class manufacturer, and we have companies that seek out our metal, our aluminum, for their manufacturing processes. So, you know, understand that at least here in Muscle Shoals, if you want to come to work in Muscle Shoals, it's not a clean plant. You're going to get out on the shop floor, you're going to get dirty, which is appealing to a lot of folks. But understand that, and I would say that probably any one of our facilities, they're dangerous on a good day. So safety is a big deal. And you need to come into this business understanding that, because, you know, safety is a safe day is where everybody goes home just tired, but the same way they came through the gate.
Thank you, Jam.
Yep.
All right. Julian, any tips?
I would say, you know, definitely put safety first always. Be productive and also be committed. And patience. Be patient, because, you know, it's different. You know, it's different in different aspects. So just be patient and trust the process and you'll be fine.
Andy, we'll wrap it up with you.
Yeah, I mean, I think for me, it's two things. It's be curious and be courageous. So be curious about what you want to do next. And, you know, as we talked about, you know, identify, or as Jam liked to say, what you want to be when you grow up, even though everyone coming out fully grown, we'll be thinking about that vision for your career, what you want to be, you know, who you want to be, where you want to be, what the right place is for you, what's the right culture for you. You know, and then just being courageous, you know, it is a journey going from active duty military or even maintaining reserve status while transitioning into full-time jobs. And, you know, whether you maintain that in the private sector or if you maintain it as a contractor to DOD and things like that, it is a different journey. So, you know, just having the courage to even start that journey, consider that journey, reach out to great organizations like ACP for help on that journey, shows a lot of courage, you know, coming from your side. And it's, you know, fully recognized and fully appreciated from companies like Constellium and others that, you know, value and really see a huge, you know, strategic benefit to partnership and hiring of veteran employees and what you all bring. So, you know, just thank you, A, for your service, but B, for, you know, looking at companies like Constellium as that next step, not only in your career, but in your life. You know, it's a big life change.
So. Gentlemen, thank you so much for sharing all of your tips. And I guess this brings us to the end of the webinar. So I just want to thank each of you for your expertise, your advice. I'd like to thank our audience for joining us virtually today. It's always such a powerful experience to connect everyone. I hope the information that was shared today helps, you know, some of our community move forward into a great career with Constellium. You can keep the conversation going by connecting with each other and our panelists. You can join our LinkedIn group, ACP Connects. And of course, you can always find the recording of this webinar here on LinkedIn or on our website. So join us every Tuesday and Thursday as we explore careers and professional development with our amazing partners. I'm J.R. Williams, and you've been watching ACP's Metal and Might, Veterans at Constellium. Have a great day.
Thanks, Jennifer.
Thanks, everyone.